Yo, what's up guys, welcome back OCG Meta Game Breakdown for August 2017. And for the decklist again, props to Yu-Gi-Oh! Organization website, all the links used, decklists, etc. Also from Ready for Duel again, the Facebook page, all the links will be in the video description. So if you want more information, more decklists, again feel free to check out the links down below. Couple of lists, or from what we were able to gather here from past 2 weeks, so the first 2 weekends of August, the amount of decklists sitting at 85, so 85 decklists, and the ban list is still the same, July 1st, 2017 for the OCG. New set still Circuit Break. As you know, a couple of important cards like Struggling Battle hitting the competitive scene. No changes, as we see here for first and second place decklist. First of all, still Dinosaurs, as we saw last week. The fact that Masterpiece got dethroned due to Dinosaurs. Dinosaurs sitting at about 32-33%, so that's about like a third of all the top and available decklists in the OCG. The most popular build, the most popular version, is the true King Yang Xing version. Again, no surprise, sitting at about 24%. And there is also like a pure version, the second possibility of running Dinosaurs. Then again, the pure version, I think all of them are also playing like that small Yang Xing engine of, you know, searching the counter trap, etc. So Dinosaurs, currently the deck to beat in the OCG. As for the decklist, it's pretty much still the same, so no changes compared to last week. Second place, no surprise, Masterpiece.deck, True Dracos, still going strong, and here is the focus here is the Spellbook engine. You know, the Spellbook deck with Invoked, the Spellbook of Rudra, Spellbook of Knowledge, I believe the TCG name is. So 24%, that's like one fourth of the entire meta, at least from the available decklist that is, that topped a particular tournament past 2 weeks in the OCG, are like True Draco, Spellbook, and Invoked. No surprises here, pretty much again the same lists. Third place, we have ABC. Again, a deck that's on the rise, or has been on the rise past 1 month, 1.5 months, you know, with Destrudo, etc., and with Dragon's Ravine. Very strong list, but it's again, I believe, as you see, we are pretty much in like a triangle format for the OCG. Two very good decks, both Dinosaurs and True Dracos, and then you have like the third deck, which is ABC. Also, I think from past weekend, pretty much, or hardly any changes. Pretty much the same with Red Dragon's Ravine, Destrudo again, with the combination to go for like Deco Talker and ABC Dragon Buster. You know, the regular shenanigans. And then place number 4 and place number 5. Both decks sitting at 5% fourth place from past week. Past 2 weeks from the decklist gathered is first of all Invoked, and here's like a pure Invoked build with or without Kaijus, Wind Witch, so only sitting at about 5%. Same for Pendulum Magician. So, you know, Pendulums are still doing okay. They're like that rogue deck, but only sitting at about 5% of the tops, which is quite decent, you know, with the new Link Rule Master Rule 4. A couple of honorable mentions from past weeks. First of all, three actually. First of all, we have Shadow Six Samurai. You know, Shadow Six Samurai. New series of Six Samurai were introduced in the OCG a couple of weeks ago. And you know, as seeing from the deck lists here, that Gateway of the Six, believe it or not, it's still at 3 in the OCG once this card, well, was, no, is. It's like a stupid card, broken card. And yet, the deck isn't really doing anything. You see that Shadow Six Samurai, or Six Samurai in general, with Triple Gateway can spam out some nice fields of Triple Firewall Dragon, and you know, the nice shenanigans with Xian as well. But still, the deck isn't strong enough to compete with the current top tier deck. So, could we possibly see Gateway coming back for us TCG players? We don't know. TCG meta or TCG Konami is way different. Second thing, and that's first of all here, BLS. We have a BLS list, like in real life picture. A couple of things. First of all, BLS itself, Envoy of the Beginning is at 3. It's ridiculous, right? Triple BLS, who would have thought that a couple of years ago? 3 BLS in the main deck, and also Grinder Golem, you know, giving it to your opponent, getting the tokens, and then go for that Link 2 Magician, bounce it back to your hand, well, bounce back Grinder Golem to your hand. So yeah, that's some cute stuff, definitely going to try that out in the near future. And last, as an honorable mention, we have, like, as you saw probably on the Yu-Gi-Oh! Organization website, I think it was like a 150-ish tournament, I believe in China, and Stargrill, so yeah, real jealous. Kaiju Agent were able to top 8, so 6th place, as you see here. Nothing too spectacular, I believe, for the build. It's main deck in Christia, the one of Exodius as well, the couple of Kaijus with a Kaiju field spell, since it's ridiculously easy to fuel your field spell, your Kaiju Waterfront, I believe the name is, to, you know, surge those Kaijus eventually. So it's still a fragile deck, so they definitely need more support. And then, yeah, as for the rogue decks, sitting at about 18%, pretty much the same as last week. I believe last week we had a little more rogue decks. We have, like, heroes, Ochamas as well, with some nice deck-like magical hats to get that Ochama trap card quickly in the grave. As for the rest, Infernoids, you know, Gras is still at 3 in the OCG, something to keep in mind. Magispectre, so Pendulums, Metal Foes, etc. So, again, for the past two weeks, not too many big changes. Still the big 3 decks, and yeah, the 2 decks leading both Dinosaurs and True Dracos, followed by that ABC deck. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Leave them standing out. Peace.